Good morning, children. All of you took out your general science reader and we begin with enrichment zone, solar system, moon and stars. Now turn to the next page, revision zone, 120, page number 120, revision zone. Fill in the blanks. The sun and the eight planets together form the solar system. Planets move round the sun in a fixed path called orbit. Earth is the only known planet with life on it. The spinning movement of Earth on its axis is called rotation. The revolution of Earth causes changes in season. All this we have learnt in this. Over here we have learnt it. Okay? Now we learn Moon. The Moon is Earth's closest neighbor. It is a natural satellite of Earth. Now moon is what? It is the Earth's closest neighbor. It is a natural satellite of Earth. A satellite is an object that goes round a planet. What is a satellite? It is an object. What is satellite? An object that goes round a planet. The moon goes round the Earth. Satellite object that goes round the planet and the moon goes round the Earth and takes about 28 days to complete one revolution. The moon has no light of its own. The moon does not have any light of its own. And why does it shine? It shines because it reflects the light of the sun. It shines why? Because it reflects the light of the sun. Learn all this for true and false. The moon has no air or water. That is why nothing can grow or live on the moon. Now moon has no air and no water. That is why nothing can grow or live on the moon. The telescope is an instrument. Now here you see, this is the telescope. This is an instrument that makes far away objects appear closer. Things which are far off, with this instrument we can easily see and it will appear very close to us and very clear. It helps in studying heavenly bodies like the moon and the star. If you have to see far off things like the moon and the star, you have to see through the telescope. When seen through a telescope, large bits are seen on the surface of the moon. Now this is the surface of the moon. When you see through the telescope, what can you see on the surface of the moon? Large bits are seen. Large bits. These bits are called craters. What these bits are called? Craters. The moon also has mountain on its surface. What does the moon have? The moon has a mountain on its surface. And these bits are called craters. The phases of the moon. If you look at the sky carefully at night, you will see that the shape of the moon appears different on different days. Now the shape of the moon will appear different on different days. Why? Because as Earth changes its position at times, we see a bigger portion of the moon lit up. Why? Because we see the bigger portion of the moon lit up. While at times we see a smaller portion of the moon lit up. When the lit up part of the moon goes on increasing, we say the moon is waxing. And when the lit up part of the moon goes on decreasing, we say the moon is waning. Now, learn both of these. Now, you see, when the lit up part of the moon which goes on increasing, we say the moon is waxing. And when the lit up part moon goes on decreasing means becoming less, we say the moon is waning. These different shapes of the moons are called phases of the moon. What are they called? Phases of the moon. Here we learn in this. What are the phases of the moon? Here. When the moon is between the sun and the earth, the side that faces the earth does not get any sunlight. So we are not able to see the moon from the earth. This is the new moon or Amavasya. Now when the moon is between what? Between the sun and the earth, the side that faces earth, what will happen? Will not get sunlight. And what will happen? So we are not able to see the moon from the earth. So what we call it? We call it the new moon or Amavasya. Then after some times, the moon starts increasing or waxing, and we are able to see the half moon. We call it half moon. After this, we see the entire moon. Entire means the full moon, the whole moon. When the moon reaches the opposite side of the earth, this is called the full moon or the Purnima. The transition between the new moon phase of the full moon phase takes 14 days. How many days will it take? 14 days. So now you will learn all this name of the moons. When do we have it? For true and false, yes or no? Okay. After the full moon, the lit up part of the moon starts decreasing or vanishing until it reaches the new moon phase. This way the cycle continues. So this way the cycle will continue. Now you see this. This is the new moon, the crescent moon, the half moon, and the gibbous moon and the full moon. Now we learn about the stars. When you look at the sky at night, you see many stars twinkling, means shining. These stars have their own light and are made up of hot gases. Stars have their own light, and what is it made up of? Hot gases. The sun is also a star. What is sun? The sun is also a star. When you look at the sky, it seems that some groups of stars, they form some stars form a pattern. These patterns are called constellation. Some well-known constellations are Great Bear, Gemini, Scorpio, Orion, Leo, and Cancer. The pole star or the north star is the brightest. The star, you call it pole star or the north star, it is the same, and it is the brightest star in the northern sky. In olden days, travelers and sailors looked at this to find the direction. Now when travelers used to travel, and the sailors, what did they do? They look at the stars to find the direction. Now this is the Orion, Great Bear, and Scorpio. Turn to the next page. Now here you will underline the correct answer. This we will do tomorrow, children. Okay, so for now you will read this again, and what I have ticked, you will learn it nicely. For true and false, yes or no, right or wrong, whatever, everything you will learn from me. Okay, so enough for now. We'll continue tomorrow. Okay, children, and have a good day.